Hello viewers, I hope you're all doing well. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to do the Celpip writing task 1. In fact, I'm here with a new letter. In Celpip, they call it the email writing. However, you don't have to give any subject line at all. And on the IELTS, like always, they say yours faithfully. You may write yours faithfully on the formal letter, but here it is better on the Celpip to give yours sincerely at the end. Let's see what we have here. Just before I get started, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel and smash the like button. Also, comment below. This way I'll be able to come up with more such videos in the future for you, which is going to benefit you. Let's see what we have. Okay. Celpip writing task 1 email to restaurant manager. So you'll be given 27 minutes. You'll have to try and attempt to write at least 185 words. If not, you'll be getting a low score. Believe me, you recently made reservation for dinner at a very famous and expensive restaurant in town. However, the meal and the service were terrible. The restaurant manager was not available to solve the problem, so you left without a resolution. Write an email to the restaurant manager in about 150 to 200 words. You are allowed to write a 10% of 200, that would be 220. Please do not exceed that. Your email should do the following things: state what problems you had with the food you ordered, complain about the service, describe how you want the restaurant to resolve the problem to your satisfaction. Okay, this is a formal letter because you do not know the restaurant manager. You can always address by saying, "Dear restaurant manager." And somebody was asking me the other day, one of my candidates, Celpip candidates, that are we allowed to write to whom it may concern on the writing task 1? It is allowed. You may write to whom it may concern because you do not know the person. Yes, in the formal letter, you can write. So let's write this one, dear. Or I may go about saying, dear sir or madam, I am writing with utmost dissatisfaction. Okay, so what do we write here? State what the problems you had with the food. Not as yet, we'll try and write. I'm writing this. Shall I say letter or shall I say email? You can say both on the Celpip because they are saying that you have to write an email to the restaurant manager. So I'm writing this letter with dissatisfaction about the service that was provided to us at your esteemed restaurant when my husband and I visited last week. Okay, so we have addressed by saying I am writing this letter with dissatisfaction about the service that was provided to us at your esteemed restaurant when my husband and I visited last week. Instead of saying, let me explain, you can go about writing one more sentence, which is the best way to write your email or letter. Furthermore, let me explain how we were treated by your staff members. Okay, so we've written the introduction. I'm writing this letter with dissatisfaction about the service that was provided to us at your esteemed restaurant when my husband and I visited last week. Furthermore, let me explain how we were treated by your staff members. Okay, let's start by saying, first and foremost, we had to wait for our turn to get a table when we had clearly called the restaurant and mentioned of the occasion. It was my husband's birthday, and I wanted to give him a bash by visiting the best restaurant in the city. However, it was a mere dismay as the food. We can start by saying when we got the table or something like that. However, it was a mere dismay. And when we finally got the table, the waiter took so long to take the order. Okay, however, it was a mere dismay. And when we finally got the table, okay, it was my husband's birthday, and I wanted to give him a bash by visiting the best restaurant in the city. However, it was a mere dismay, and when we finally got the table, the waiter took so long to take the order. Moreover, when the orders arrived, the starters were stale and looked as though they were remnants from yesterday. Now, what problems you had with the food you ordered? Complain about the service. Now, let's get on with the service. Secondly, when we complained to the waiter, he misbehaved and started neglecting us, and the further orders or and the further main course were delayed in this process. Okay, secondly, when we complained to the waiter, he misbehaved and started neglecting us. Therefore, further, the main course were delayed in this process. So, further, the main course meaning what? It is probably the main meal of the day. I was very embarrassed with this situation and was hoping that my husband took it. Lightly. Okay, so I was very embarrassed with the situation and was hoping that my husband took it lightly. Then what additionally, or you can say, complain about the service, describe how you want the restaurant to resolve the problem to your satisfaction. Okay. Finally, you can say, yeah, finally, I would request you to take cognizance of this matter as you would lose many valued customers with this kind of behavior by your staff members. Okay, let's not drag it further. Let's try to finish it. Finally, I would request you to take cognizance of this matter as you would lose many valued customers with this kind of behavior by your staff member. Then what? Additionally, you may give them some valuable training on customer satisfaction. Okay, finally, I would request you to take cognizance of this matter as you would lose many valuable customers with this kind of behavior by your staff members. Additionally, you may give them some valuable training on customer satisfaction. I hope you understood the gravity of the situation, and I look forward to hearing from you soon. Yours sincerely, Sally. Okay, so the one difference I was already talking about was that yours sincerely or yours faithfully, like how we address on the IELTS, but in Celpip we address this particular formal letter with yours sincerely and with your name. So never give XYZ, like I always say in my other videos. Let's do the proofreading once. Dear sir or madam, I'm writing this letter with dissatisfaction about the service that was provided to us at your esteemed restaurant when my husband and I visited last week. Furthermore, let me explain how we were treated by your staff members. First and foremost, we had to wait for our turn to get a table when we had clearly called the restaurant and mentioned of the occasion, about the occasion. We can change it to about the occasion. It was my husband's birthday, and I wanted to give him a bash by visiting the restaurant, best restaurant in the city. However, it was a mere dismay, and when we finally got the table, the waiter took so long to take the order. Moreover, when the orders arrived, the starters were stale and looked as though they were remnants from yesterday. Secondly, when we complained to the waiter, he misbehaved and started neglecting us. Therefore, further, the main course were delayed in this process. I was very embarrassed with the situation and was hoping that my husband took it lightly. Finally, I would request you to take cognizance of this matter, as you would lose many valued customers with this kind of behavior by your staff members. Additionally, you may give them some valuable training on customer satisfaction. I hope you understood the gravity of the situation, and I look forward to hearing from you soon. Yours sincerely, Sandy. I'm not even writing that, you have to refund, or next time when I visit, you better take care of us in a better way by serving us costly food and things like that. I've just written it in a way it should be written, by not writing anything extra up to the point. So, viewers, I hope you enjoyed this video. Like I said earlier, please do subscribe to my channel. This way, I'll be able to come up with more such videos in the future, which is going to be of benefit to you. This is Sridhar signing off from Celpip Academy. See you on the other side. Thanks for watching.